Hello guys, John Talley with Partzilla.com, locked away in my own shop in seclusion because of the coronavirus. But I was going to show you a little trick that I learned for extracting bolts that may be frozen and snapped off. What I've done here is I've driven on a nut on the end of the offending bolt. And what we're going to do is weld on the inside of it. And hopefully that'll give me enough torque without shearing it off to get it to release. So let's get it tacked in place and see if we can get it to back out of there. Gonna be fun. All right, guys, she is welded up in there. I'm gonna let it cool just a bit, make sure it's set. Then I'm gonna heat up this area with a torch. And we'll see if we can get this booger to back out of there. So after 5 attempts, the only thing we were able to do is make it just a little bit shorter now. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna center punch that guy, drill it out, and then use a Time-Sert, because that's really the only option I have left at this point. Certainly not giving up, but the battle plans have changed. So I've got the initial pilot hole drilled. Now we're gonna go through about 2 or 3 more sizes up incrementally until we can get to the threads, and then we'll stop and then wait for the Time-Sert, because it has a very specific diameter drill bit that you have to use. And I certainly don't wanna guess and guess wrong. So I'm gonna grab the next larger drill bit and work my way toward those threads. There's our next step. I'm thinking about 2 more should do it. So we're almost there, but as you can tell, it's just a little off center. You know, that started with the pilot hole, and that's almost impossible to do dead on. But that actually works to my advantage, because what I'll do is use the same drill bit and just wallow it back and forth and take out that edge. And at that point, most of this material will be gone, and I can just knock it in and then pull out the rest. And that will expose just the threads. Let's see if I can get it to collapse in on itself using a hammer and a chisel. Several hours later, it is out. Now I just have to wait for the Time-Sert, re-drill this, and get the new threads in there. Well, here is our Time-Sert kit. We're trying to use a regular one instead of going to the big cert. And here is one of the Time-Serts, but the question is that going to be too big to go inside there? And the answer is yes, just barely. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to Time-Sert it in reverse, because we have to countersink it in there. That's really our only choice. So that's what I'm going to go for. Well, she's in. My new dowel still fits in there. I think we're gonna be good to go. All right, guys, it does work. It may be off a tick, but it'll have enough play in the transmission housing to where I can get it bolted back up. Well, there you have it. That was a bit of a fight, and my trick that I was gonna show y'all, it didn't work, so we had to take it to the next level. Listen, I hope everybody stays safe out there, and hopefully this virus thing will come to an end here shortly, and we can get back to whatever you consider normal. Well, until then, if you need any parts for your machine while you're stuck at home, why don't you come see us at Partzilla.com? We will get you taken care of, even though it may take a little bit longer because of the shortage of people that we have to actually get these packages out. But at any rate, it will make it to you. Listen, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Partzilla, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all stay safe out there. Have a great day.